in the last video, we have seen the basic things regarding the erotophilic reactions. So now let us see the mechanism of erotophilic substitution reaction of benzene with respect to halogenation. So we know that when you take the benzene now, in case of benzene, we got the 3 double bonds. So because it has got the 3 double bonds, the pi electrons are there. We know the pi electrons are present here. So they can start moving from one carbon to the other carbon, making one carbon positive. That is, which is losing will become positive and which will be gaining will become negative. So when a positive thing and a negative thing is created, because we know that electrophiles are E plus, they are positive in nature. So E plus electron deficient, so they can move towards the negative sign. So benzene plus, when you take the halogenation, for example Cl2, it will give chlorobenzene. I have let the Cl here plus HCl, the plus of a catalyst AlCl3. So this is the reaction of halogenation of benzene or chlorination of benzene. Now let's go to the mechanism. So mechanism, it involves like 3 steps. So the step 1 will be generation of electrophile. I will write E plus, generation of electrophile. So generation of electrophile. So we know the chlorine is here. So chlorine, I will write one chlorine and one chlorine here, Cl2 plus AlCl3. So what happens in this case, one bond is equal to 2 electrons. So when I put an arrow mark, it indicates that the bond contains 2 electrons. So both electrons will move towards this chlorine. So this chlorine will be gaining the electron and this will be losing the electron. So for understanding, one chlorine becomes Cl plus, which is losing the electron becomes Cl plus. If this is gaining, this becomes Cl minus. So the chlorine which is losing the electron to this chlorine becomes a positive part and this will become negative part. So this AlC3, it is electron deficient. AlCl3 itself is electron deficient, because we know that in case of AlCl3, it is Al, we have discussed in the last video. So two electrons. To attain the octet, it will be interesting. So what happens? This chlorine with the 2 electrons will go and attack with the aluminium. So that aluminium octets will be solved. So net what is remaining, this Cl minus will go and join there. Here Cl plus will be remaining. So I'll be having the Cl plus AlCl4 minus. So now this will be the electrophile. And the name of this electrophile is chloronium ion. It will be chloronium ion. So this will be the thing. So generation of electrophile is the first step. So next step will be addition of electrophile to the benzene ring. We know that in this case electrophile was Cl plus. So let us understand the mechanism here now. So let me take the benzene ring. So when I write the benzene ring, alternate to double and single bonds. So what will happen to this benzene ring? This benzene ring, assume that the 2 electrons, when I put an arrow mark, the 2 pi electrons, they will move towards this carbon. So when I put the arrow mark like this. So what happens is, when you put the arrow mark like this, electrons are moving from this carbon to this carbon. So this carbon is losing the electron. The bond will not be there, because the electrons which are involved in the bond, they move towards this carbon. So these 2 bonds will remain as such. This double bond, this double bond. So here this carbon will have a negative sign, and this carbon which has lost will have a positive sign. So it is between the carbon and carbon, sigma bond is present. Now both electrons will move towards this carbon. So this carbon will gain the electron, it will have the negative sign. This carbon is going to lose the electron, it will have the positive sign. Now we have to check whether this is stable or not. See, whenever you have a, for example now, when you take this bond, it is a single bond. So single bond will be a sigma bond. So single bond will be sigma bond. Then we got a double bond. So here it comes pi bond. And here we got a positive charge. We got a positive charge. So now we have to check whether this structure is stable or not. And this is very interesting and very important, because any structure which has got a sigma bond followed by pi and a positive charge, it is very stable now. So this is very stable. This is very stable now. So we can see a single bond which is sigma and the double bond which is pi, then we got a positive charge. So this thing we call it as sigma complex. Very, very important for the competitive exams. So this will exist because it is stable now. Now what will happen? The coronium ion, which is having the positive sign, we know that all the way it will go and attack here. So now what will be the product now? It will be like this, still having these two double bonds. Here we have got a Cl. Please remember, each and every part of the carbon is attached with even a hydrogen. So I will show this hydrogen also here. Still the positive charge will be remaining here. So this will be the product. Now we have added the electrophile to the benzene ring. So the last step will be removal of H plus electrophile. So we have to remove this electrophile, because we know already we have got a AlCl4 in the reaction. AlCl4 minus is there. Now let us take this structure now. So we have a Cl and we have got a HCl. Now what happens? This hydrogen will come out as H plus. Why? Because in this bond, carbon hydrogen bond, we got two electrons. So one is with carbon, one is with hydrogen. When the hydrogen moves out as H plus, now two electrons are present. So once again, a carbon-carbon bond can be formed. So to regain the aromaticity, aromaticity means to get back all the three double bonds. Now we are only two double bonds are there. So this H plus will move out. So that what happens is these two electrons, the two electrons which are present between the carbon and hydrogen, now it can form a bond between the carbon and carbon, because to form a bond, we need two electrons. So we can make use of these two electrons. So I'll put an arrow mark here. So they are slowly moving here. So we'll get a double bond once again. So the final structure will be, I can write like this. So here on bond, after H plus moves out, the two electrons will make a bond here. So we'll get one more double bond here. Here's a double bond, and I'll be having the Cl, which is your chlorobenzene. And the H plus which is coming out, we know that what happens is, we already got that AlCl4 minus. So that will react with the AlCl4. You will get once again the AlCl3 plus the HCl, because H plus and 1, Cl will react to form the HCl and AlCl3. So this will complete the mechanism of halogenation of benzene.